Perfect. So, what problem actually you already faced after?
Here in the, so we had some sales, but I cannot see them here. Hang on.
So these sales actually come from Google Ads or organic sales?
I'm not sure. I think probably from Google Ads.
Okay.
But I'm not sure.
But
because we are running ads, so it's
okay. We can say very easily. Just go to the conversion section in Google Ads.
Yeah, this one.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. This one. This one is the one we created last time.
Okay.
And then you see no conversions.
No conversion. That means no sales actually generated from these Google Ads. That's why it's, is it verified or unverified showing? That is actually showing verified or unverified. Actually, I can't understand where basically it is Swedish language. So is it showing, that means unverified or verified?
It doesn't say verified or unverified. It just says no conversion in the last few days.
Okay, no conversion. Okay, no problem. Today's...
Here we have another conversion, which is called just purchase. But it was the one I used before without the value. And here you see 69 conversions in total, so that one works.
Okay, but you did not get any value, right?
Yeah. No,
okay.
No value. Here, this one is the checkout, if they have checkout. So it's totally 240 conversions, but I think this is far too high because we did not have 240 sales. But I think I gave the value of $2, I think. That's why here it says 480.
Okay.
You know, because this one also doesn't track the value. I just set the value to $2.
Okay, and just edit this one, edit this, just
the checkout.
Last one. What actually we did earlier?
This one?
Uh-huh. Edit. And website. Just edit once. Just click edit button.
This is finish.
Oh, that is finish.
Yeah,
okay.
Finish. We can already edit.
Okay, one thing. All. Okay, all website.
Yeah. Web source.
Okay.
We can't edit this one. Source is website.
Better to keep pause this. We can create another one. What do you think?
Okay.
Because actually, just pause or delete, no problem.
I cannot pause. Only can.
Okay, we can remove this, no problem. Just we will create again. Or just keep this, just keep. Okay, delete it, no problem. So, create again.
Okay. New one.
Website. And
purchase, right?
Purchase.
Yeah, it's this.
Just read purchase. And okay, tracking website purchase value. Okay, what you can understand. That is the thing.
Or I say take today.
Okay.
Today
and 15. Select you have different value. just select you have different value.
This one, Unterschied, yeah. No. Different value for each conversion, yeah, and then...
What's the last one?
No value.
No value. Okay, so different value. Okay, just here is one or two, anything you can put. Anything one, just one.
I say, you know, this one is the cheapest product, so this is 26.
No, it actually comes from dynamically from there. We will put one. It's not actually...
It says if it's not possible to track the value, right, it will take this one.
Oh, just you have to put more than one. I mean value will be more than one or something like that. Okay, 20 things, no problem. And all we will say 30, okay, just click.
Okay,
everything is okay, no problem. Okay.
Tag, right?
And now go to the tag manager. And just we will edit. Just we will edit the previous tag.
This one, right?
This one, persist tag. Might be AI. Same thing. Might be same. No. Should be value will be same. Yeah, conversion level can be different, but same. Okay, and DLV purchase value, just click, no, just click right side. DLV purchase value, just select select DLV purchase value. Okay.
Two times.
So just delete one first and select that. Okay, fantastic. And just delete. And ID. And conversion track is.
Does this work like that or not?
What's actually that?
That's the currency code.
Currency you can put just CASB, no problem.
But is this for good for code or?
If you have multiple currency, then you have to put, then you have to take from dynamically. But if you use single currency, if you have single currency, so you can put directly, no problem. Okay. No need anything to, and purchase tag just just save it, no problem, everything is okay, just save it. Just we will check once now if it's work here. 100% it will work for universally, I mean if anyone comes from Google Ads. So just preview mode.
I think I know what happened. Did we publish last time?
Published. You have to publish must.
Yeah, I think we didn't publish last time.
Really?
I'm not sure. Hang on. Ah, no. For 3 days. Where can I see the versions?
That is the version. That's the version.
You know, but where can I see if we published last time?
I don't know, but I can't remember actually. So might be.
Okay.
It can be.
So like just like that, and then I can...
Just publish.
Publish.
Just publish.
Yeah, I think we did not publish.
Might be. So now just go to preview mode.
buy something.
Yeah. Just purchase anything. Okay. Just go to so tag is fired or not? And last one.
Go to tags are fired, yeah.
Okay. So just select left corner from shake out. Just click on shake out from the left corner. Go up. Yes, exactly. So it actually fired. 100% it will work. So if come on, if anyone come from Google Ads and if he or she buy any product, 100% it will work. Not a problem. With value. Okay, just finish here. Just is this finished, right? Yeah. Okay. 100% it will work.
Okay, then we will see it here, right?
You can see here, as well as if you go to select campaign, just go to the select campaign, just select the campaign, individual campaign. Is this individual campaign? No.
Yes. Search ad and then one ad group.
Okay, just select a specific campaign from all campaigns. This one, right? So might be, is this campaign, but from right side, just click on from right side, campaign, update, keyword, like that. Left side menu.
And then?
No, you can select from left side menu. Right side menu. This one.
Control, hang on, how can I give you control? Here.
Actually,
you can try. Yeah, you can try.
Might be. Oh, it's working, right? Oh, is this campaign?
No, that's product groups. This is ad group.
Okay, is this campaign?
No, this one is all campaign, right? All campaign.
Oh, so. So here you will see, just 1 minute, you will see conversion. We need conversion value, right? So if you want to conversion value, that is what actually this?
This one is the columns.
Columns. Okay.
Yeah, columns.
Columns. And this one?
Segment.
Segment. This one?
Columns.
Columns. So from columns, we can take just write conversion here. Conversion value. Just write conversion value here.
Where?
Conversion value.
I don't see.
No conversion value here?
This one is conversion.
Just write conversion value. Did you get any?
This one. This is value all conversion.
Exactly. Just click on that. Just click on that and select. Okay, here is your conversion rate, conversion value, conversion per click, everything you can check. Just tick mark and select that.
Okay,
and finish. I mean, selected. No need, you can just select. So, here you will get the conversion value. Did you get conversion value? So that is the conversion value. I mean the exact amount of money.
Yeah, but that's the one from the other conversion tag we had before. You know, that always takes the same value of 2.
Okay, so you are getting just 2, right?
Yeah, before, yeah.
Okay. So from now on, might be you will get the exact value. If someone come from Google Ads, two website, and then if come and then purchase any product from website, then you will get the value. Might be that is the formula actually. So
okay, good. Then
it will work, must. Lots of website I have worked.
Very good, okay. I have here another campaign with a smart shopping campaign.
Okay.
It doesn't really run. I only have 1,000 impressions.
Is it shopping campaign? I mean shopping ads or
yes,
PPC?
Smart shopping.
Smart shopping actually for very newbie. So smart for a expert, I think you should use standard shopping campaign. Smart shopping campaign works. Machine learning behind that. So sometimes it's not work properly because machine learning is not up to date or expert. So better if you do standard shopping campaign, and maximum expert suggests that. So smart shopping campaign, actually who does not know enough about shopping campaign, Google Ads like that, for them actually.
Okay.
So better, beside this, or you can pause this and create a new one. So that would be better, I think.
Okay, good, then I will do that later, yeah. Here, I accidentally just... Okay, you know, because this one is the shopping ad you see for cashmere products, and now I want to create second campaign for only cashmere products.
Okay. Just select sales, right? Sales, shopping, and okay, that is connected.
Standard
campaign. That would be better. Basically first time if you want to control the campaign, so better for the first time you should use manual CPC or enhanced CPC.
This one only works if the value tracking is correct.
Exactly, value tracking, and the last 13 days you have minimum you have to 15 conversion, then it will works good. But now you can use enhanced e-commerce. That is very good for sales campaign, and you can control also your bid. So if you use enhanced e-commerce, enhanced PPC, that is maximize clicks. Maximize clicks is not good for shopping campaign.
Okay, yeah,
so you can use manual CPC. Manual CPC and enhanced CPC. Enhanced CPC always very good. Just skip it. Everything is skip.
Where is enhanced? I don't see.
Enhanced. That is actually enhanced. Auto optimization CPC conversion rate.
This one, this is enhanced.
Exactly, exactly. Enhanced means if you select per click budget $1, $2, if you select enhanced CPC, Google will optimize. Google will take 30% more or 30% less to bid. I mean to win the bid, but not more that. So if you select $1, Google sometimes will cut 130 cent, not 2 cent, 3 cent, not $2, $3, lot like that. So it's control, but very good for shopping campaign. Okay, budget. Okay, everything. No. Don't use that. So it's not work actually properly. Only sorts and as well as what is that? Search partner might be right.
This is YouTube, Gmail.
You mean just no need for shopping campaign. This one actually. Just be, no. Below search. That tick mark actually.
This one.
No. Just go up. Audience network, right? Audience network. That is a partner. You can deselect the partner also. No need to partner site. Okay. That is the good for the shopping ad. No need. Okay. Now everything is okay. Just select the country or location. If
yeah,
okay, no
good,
problem.
That's good.
Okay, so if
yeah,
okay,
next.
Okay, next, add group name, right? Just
right?
One, no problem, you can set one.
What would you do?
So, if you set one, and we actually use enhanced CPC, so Google maximum will cut 1.3 CASF, not more than that.
Okay.
30% increase and decrease. Google will decrease 30% increase or 30% decrease, not more than. So it actually controlled by us.
Yeah, but you know, I don't know how the competition is, so I don't know what the click.
After getting certain click, you will understand what Excel you need. So you can select 1.5 or 1, no problem. But if you select 5, that means it does not mean actually Google will cut $5. Google actually do real-time auction. So if you select $5 or $7, Google will cut $5, $7. No, not like this.
Yeah. You know, here there's all products, but I don't want to use all products. I just want to take felt products, right?
Okay.
Then I can go here.
Mm-hmm.
Or how do I do? This one.
Yeah. You can, but you have to select. Sometimes.
This all not.
You can select this.
Good. And then save, right?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 product, right? Okay.
No, it's this one is the number. This is the group. This is the product.
Oh, so lots of product. No product.
Yeah.
Okay, you can just select.
And then I can pause all others, right? Because that's the rest, right?
Oh, yeah. I mean, in this ad group, those are the product which actually you want to promote, right? So just pause all group and select the individual product. Okay.
Yeah, good.
Sometimes actually I can't understand what actually that, because it's Swedish language. So everything is okay, right?
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
Okay.
that's good. Can you also have a quick look here? You know, here I said different prices for different scarves. You know, because this one is a cheaper one, and for this one is a more expensive one, so I used a higher bid, right?
Google actually shows for that product what actually is this automated?
Yeah, auto optimize.
Okay, so Google actually shows how much it will cut after clicking any product.
Should I change something here?
I think for the first time we can say that if it is automated, no need to change anything. We can say it.
Or should we not automate? Should we make it manually?
It would be better after running any ad 1 or 2 days, so you will get actual cost, then you can do manually. I mean, if you increase for few product, you can decrease for few product, because after a certain days you will actually understand what product actually is your winner product. I mean, what product actually sell more. So which product actually sell more, you have to increase the bid for those products, so that will work and that will bid with competitors betterly. That's the thing.
Okay. Here you see 80 impressions, only one click, or 100 and one click. That's quite bad, no?
Click actually better 1% is very less. You should have minimum 3 to 5% CTR.
Yeah. What do you think is the problem here?
Problem can be title optimization. Can be.
Here I see it's always color red, which is very bad. And I think this one is the main competitive one. You know, the color red is the most favorite one, so everyone is searching for that.
Okay.
So there's a lot of competition. I don't know.
Lots of competition, but you can, 125 or 150 character is best for title optimization. So your product title, actually we need to check the product title. Your product title should be 150 character, but very attractive. Actually, how your user actually search, so title should be according to search term with attribute, not like that free shipping, not like that. Just title should be according to, okay.
I show you the merchant center.
Just merchant center. You can go from there. Just go to Google Ads. Just Google Ads, settings, tools and settings, is it? Go to the merchant center. Exactly. Yeah. So it's a very good way.
You see the scarves here. It's women's cashmere scarf, and then the name. This one is the name of the product, and then the color, and 100% cashmere.
I think it is good. That is the good title. That is the good title. That is good.
What do you think is the problem? Is the image?
Can you search so that we can seek the what actually at showing? That is.
See the first one. The first one is us.
First one, I think it's not a good image, but another one is, I think, very good image.
This one is also us, and this one is also us.
Image is not good, boss. Friend, I think you should take the image. Basically, from your image, I can't understand what actually that. But beside that, you can understand what actually. Is it visible? I mean, makes sense. What actually this?
Yeah. What would you change?
Might be you should change the image.
Sorry.
Might be you should change the image. Your photography is not very good.
Yeah. What photograph would you use? Something like that.
Exactly. What actually makes sense? What actually that? But what product actually is that? But if I see your product, I can't understand what actually. Exactly. I can't understand what product actually is that. So I think should be changed the product. That's why CTR is very less.
Okay.
I think that.
Okay, I understand. Yeah.
So for the feed management, what tools actually you are using? You are putting manually or feed management tool? Okay, WooCommerce Feed Pro, na? Right?
That's exactly, that one.
That is very good plugin. Product Feed Pro for WooCommerce.
Yes, exactly. So, but the problem, so the name is good, and I think, you know, the ad is showing up 3 times, so that's very good. But the image, right?
Image should be seen. Because you can see just. I mean, your competitor image and your image, just compare them, you will understand.
Okay. Yeah, good. So I have to make new pictures for. That's not easy.
No, yeah, just you have to put manually one by one. Then feed automatically push to the
WhatsApp. Also with, you know, white background and then cut it out, yeah.
You can do that also. So it should be more visible.
Yeah, because I think, what do you think? The woman is better than this one, right? What do you prefer?
I think if it's a dress, full dress, that woman is better. But if you use just accessories, I mean here, hand, I mean few accessories, I mean not a main product. So that is it's better. But if a full dress, that is women's is better.
Okay, good. This one I also like.
Yeah, so it's more visible.
Okay, good. So we have to change that.
Okay,
so I know it's already late.
We will work tomorrow again, no problem. But if you want, I can do, no problem.
Yeah, because we wanted to have a look at analytics too, right?
It's actually analytics 4, right?
Yeah.
It's analytics 4.
One main thing I wanted to do is, to make sure that when I watch the page, that it doesn't show up here. Exclude my IP address or something.
Better for enhanced e-commerce, better if you use Google Analytics 3, I mean Universal Analytics, because very soon Google will publish new update for Google Analytics 4. Google Analytics 4 not established, I mean stable yet.
This is 3, right?
This is 3. So bitter you can use for enhanced e-commerce, and after getting update from Google for Google Analytics 4, then we can use Google Analytics 4 for enhanced e-commerce. So Google actually suggests you have to use Google Analytics 4 and it works parallelly, not fully shift to Google Analytics 4. So better if we use Google Analytics right now. That is doing better. After getting update from Google, then we can use Google Analytics 4. And lots of update will come for Google Analytics 4. And very soon. So,
okay, good.
So
you know, we can leave that. Then I will look if the conversions work. And then I have to make a lot of new photos.
Okay, so we will sit tomorrow. We will sit tomorrow, no problem. Okay, no problem, friend.
It's going to take probably a week or something, yeah.
Okay, so we can sit tomorrow or two day after tomorrow as your convenient time. I'm ready.
Okay, good, perfect, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, thank you. Then you can also send me again the offer in, you know, in Fiverr.
Okay, sure. I will make you. So,
thank you very much for the help.
Thank you. We will work gradually, and we will do best something. Must.
Yeah.
So, are you enjoying to work with me?
I'm sorry?
Are you enjoying to work with me?
Yeah, it's very good. I like it over Zoom. It's very good.
Thank you very much. Thank you. I am also very happy to work with you.
Yeah, that's good.
That's good.
So talk to you soon then.
Okay, sure. Thank you.
And yeah, you can send me on Fiverr.
Oh, sure. I will send you a customer.
Okay. Well, take some
time. Okay, bye-bye.
Yeah. Bye.
Fine. Thank you very much.